I really loved my time at Knife. I've had so many great memories there, too many to pick a favourite, and I'll really miss all of my friends and all the teachers there.
One of my favourite memories was when I first walked into Mr. Buckland's class, and for months I didn't know what I was going to do because I didn't know him as my teacher, but because he was a teacher assistant before that and never been my teacher before, but after a while it kind of developed and I kind of knew him a bit better, and all of my friends and Mr. Buckland together, it was just best time in school, and I just wanted to say thank you to Mr. Buckland and all my friends, and goodbye.
My favourite memory of school when I met all my friends, and I also loved the bit when we went to the Remo Museum. Bye!
My favourite was Victorian's Day, and we got to dress up and had lessons with no lights on and no electricity.
I'm going to miss Knives so much. It's pretty much been my whole life so far. I'm going to miss all my friends, the teachers, just everything. We did some amazing, amazing plays at school. We had some amazing songs we learned. We've had so much fun, and I just don't know what I'm going to do without the school. The teachers are just the best. They are so kind, helpful and loving, and they try to make the school very much better, even though it doesn't need to be better. They're helping so much, and if I'm stuck on my work, they'll come over, explain it, and I should get it after that. They're just amazing, and I'm gonna miss everyone at the school because it's just the best school ever.
Necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities, or Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I couldn't be found off my big home. The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe try a few. The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you.
My favourite memory of being at Knife is going up in assembly to get my well-earned dojo trophy. Thank you, Mr. Buckland, for having me and being an excellent teacher. And also, thank you for all the staff that looked after me. Thank you!
My favourite memory from Knife Primary School is all the laughs and fun memories that we've made together.
One of my best memories was being a dead body in the Victorian class assembly.
Hello, Knife, and I have had such good memories at this school, and it's been definitely the best school that I've been to. Thank you so much for all the support that everybody has gave me and how welcomed into the class I've been. It's definitely been good.
Thank you. Welcome to Pudding Lane. I am really sorry about the fire, but how did it happen in today?
Thomas Farnham forgot to turn off his oven and flames come out sparkling like flames.
It's Jade. I will really miss my teachers and my friends when I leave Knive, and I really hope to see you all soon.
My favourite thing about Knive was when I joined the school football team and made lots of new friends.
Hi, it's Caitlin. I'd just like to say a huge thank you to everyone who's helped me throughout Knive, and also my best memory was when we all made slime together and it's really fun.
Hi everyone, it's me Katie, and I would say that my favourite moments at Knife were definitely getting to know and spend time with all of you guys, and of course Mr. Buckland. And don't ever think this is the goodbye, because it's only the start of hellos. I miss you all so much. You are my torch in the dark, the snow to my winter, and my bestest friends. I know it won't be the same, but I can promise one thing for certain, and that is that we will never stop at loving you guys. I will keep in touch and never forget you all. Thank you for the absolute time of my life. And just quickly, Mr. Buckland, make sure that Caitlin realises that Pac-Man is not a honeydew melon. Love your favourite head, Katie. Bye everyone.
Oh, was playing for the school football team. I enjoyed all my time at Knife. I will miss all the teachers, especially Mr. Button.
My favourite memories at Knife would be probably when my first day when I met everyone, because everyone was so kind to me, and they made me feel welcome and part of everything. And then the other one would be when I first joined the football club, because it was just like me being me. I just felt like I was in my element, and everyone there made me feel welcome and happy. And I just felt at home there.
I've loved having so many good friends at Knife, and I've loved how the teachers have just made learning so fun for us.
Hey everybody! One of my favourite memories I'm going to have at Knife were the school trips and the assemblies. I especially enjoyed the Victorian assembly and being Queen Victoria, because I liked her script a lot. I'm going to miss you guys a lot. I'm going to miss the teachers and the students. And even though I'm still going to be with some of you guys at secondary school, I'm still going to miss the rest of you a lot. And I hope we can still keep in touch and everything. And I'm going to obviously miss the teachers teaching. And yeah, bye. 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 Bye.
I really enjoyed all the moments with all the teachers, especially with Mr. Buckland, to taking me from there until now. I've really enjoyed all the moments what I've done, so thank you, and I hope you have a lovely future.
Hi, it's Olivia. I really miss the year 6 class a lot. Even though we weren't the best of friends, we were still really good friends, and school's like home away from home for me, so I don't know what I'll do without it. And
I really enjoyed my time at Knife, especially when we were reading all the good books like A Series of Unfortunate Events and books by Darren Chan. I also enjoyed it when Luke shouted out in the middle of class, "Have I been a good boy?" Not to make it sad, but I'll miss you.
Hi, this is Darren Chan, and I'd just like to say a big farewell to all the Year 6s of Knife Primary School. A little bat tells me that I've got quite a few fans over there and that you'll enjoy my books before the lockdown. I'm sorry you didn't get around to Demonata, but hopefully next year at secondary school, a teacher or librarian will be able to track those down for you. I hope you have a great summer break, and you come back rested and full of vim and verve in September for your first year of secondary school. I'm sure it's going to be brilliant. Take care, and see you all again soon. Cheers.
Hello there, pupils of Mr. Buckland's class. It's Darren Simpson here. I'm the author of this book here, Scavengers, which I believe you've all read in class. I'm so glad to hear you enjoyed it. And thank you to Mr. Buckland for bringing it into class in the first place. This is a quick message to wish you all the best for secondary school. A bit scary maybe, isn't it? But also really exciting. I hope you'll have a great time. Stay in touch with your friends, of course, from this school. And good luck making new friends. Friends are so important. They do us so much good, I think, as we've learned through the pandemic. We've all missed them a lot, I'm sure. And also, Keep reading, of course. I'm biased, but reading does you so much good, especially if you keep on doing it. Just keep looking for those books that you enjoy, that inspire you. It's a good thing. So yeah, all the best and bye-bye.
Hello, 9th Primary School, Year 6, and Mr. Buckland's class. I am Peter Bunzel, the author of this book, Cogheart, which I hear you read with your class this year. And I just wanted to get in touch and wish you a fantastic end of term and a happy onward journey into Year 7 and secondary school. It's been a weird few months for you, I imagine, being at home and learning online, and now back at school, but in little bubbles, so you don't get to see everyone all the time. But I still hope you have a fantastic end of term and do lots of fun stuff and enjoy lots of reading and writing and great activities to finish off the school year. So good luck with everything and good luck with your new adventures in secondary school.
I will never forget my time at Live and all my teachers. Mrs. Watts, you remember that time when we were learning about the digestive system? That was really funny, wasn't it? And I will miss all my teachers really much, and especially Mr. Buckland, because he has inspired me to become the best I can be. I will miss all of you so much, my friends. Bye!
Hi. My favourite memory at school is having fun with my friends and the teachers.
Takk fyrir þetta, Sara. Glæsilegt hjá þér. Ha. Og svo erum við með næsta tónlistaratriði. Það Daði og Gagnamagnið. Think about things.
Believe it, I will always be there, so you
to say by the way, at least I'll be there, baby. I can't wait to know, what do you think about things? Believe it, I will always be there, so you can tell me anything and I'll listen.
Hi, my name is Dale Freyr, and I just wanted to say thank you for listening. The response to Think About Things has been overwhelming. Stay healthy, stay fabulous, you guys are beautiful.
Hello, Year 6, Ninth. Absolute pleasure to be talking to you. Your teacher, Mr. Buckland, said that you're moving on to secondary school, and I wanted to congratulate you for finishing primary under extraordinary circumstances. Thank you for joining me for our lessons on Oak National Academy during lockdown. I hope that you enjoyed finding out all about 20th century conflict and looking at population, and that's going to set you up really well for your time in secondary, because you'll have already done some really tough work and be super smart and probably blow away all of your teachers there. I know that you're going to have an amazing time in this next step in your adventure. I'm actually really jealous of you going into secondary school. It's really exciting. So have a brilliant, brilliant move up. Well done for everything that you've achieved over the last few months. You rock and take care.
Hi, Mr. Fodlad here. Just sending a message to the Year 6s at Knife Primary School. Thank you for taking part in our online lessons with the Oak National Academy. And I just want to wish you a massive good luck as you move on to secondary school. Take care.
Hi Year 6, just wanted to wish you all the best on the next part of your education into secondary school. For many of you, I remember you as small 2 and 3 year olds starting your education back at Knife Preschool. Wow, look at you all now, haven't you grown? We're all so proud of what you've achieved at school. Remember that your school years are going to be the best years of your life, and you'll look back on all of these lovely, wonderful memories that you're making. Have a fantastic summer, take care, and best of luck in your secondary schools. Bye!
Hi Year 6, just wanted to say good luck on your journey to secondary school. You are all going to be amazing and we're really going to miss you. Keep working hard and all the best for your future. Lots of love.
Hi Year 6, we just wanted to leave you a message to give you some memories of when we were your teachers in Year 3. So first of all, Mayan Day. That was so fun when we did the topic, the Mayans, and we had a day when we dressed up as the Mayans and got to try some of the food. Mr. Conlon, do you remember?
Yes. So do you remember when we made pita breads and they tasted like sand? That wasn't very
I don't think we followed the recipe very well. The other thing I remember was our trip to Cotswold Wildlife Park. That was really fun.
Do you remember when we watched The Witches and it was all gory and it wasn't very nice, and you've never watched it, have you, Mrs. Amber?
I've never seen that before, so I was not expecting that to happen.
No.
So yeah, it was really good. And I know there's many more memories, but we don't want to take up the whole of your video. So we just want to say good luck when you go to secondary school. You've been amazing. It's lovely to see you grow, and I hope that you have a lovely summer before you start. We'll miss you loads.
Hi, Year 6. I just wanted to wish you the best of luck for secondary school. I'm sure you'll be great. I'm really going to miss seeing you all around next year. Hope you have a super summer. Bye.
Hi Year 6. Just wishing you the very best of luck as you move on to secondary school and beyond. Take care and good luck. Bye.
Hello Year 6. I just wanted to let you know what a privilege it's been to watch you grow from your very first day in reception class to the fabulous bunch of young people that you are today. I know that you've all got great futures ahead of you, so keep being positive, have fun and make the most of every opportunity that's available to you. Come back and let us know how you're getting on, because we'd love to see you again. Good luck!
Hi Year 6!
I would like to wish you so much luck when you move to secondary school. I know you are all going to be fabulous, and we are so proud of everything that you've achieved while you've been at Nyth. You have been a fantastic year six. So wish you lots of luck and hope that you'll come back to visit us. Bye.
Okay, here we go. Hi year six. I have had so much fun making this video, looking back at all the amazing things that we've done since we've been together, since year two, which seems like such a long time ago. It has been such a joy to look back at all the videos and photos and all the memories that we've shared together. But this is the part of the video that I've not been looking forward to, because this is the part of the video when I have to say goodbye to you, which is a really, really hard thing to do. Thinking back to year two, when I first joined Nyth, you were my first class, my first proper class as a teacher. And from the minute that I met you all, I knew that we were going to have an incredible time together, because you were such a fun, happy, loving class that works so well as a team. You all gel together so well, every single one of you. And the care and love that you have for one another, even if you may not admit it, is amazing. And I've never known a class that get along so well together and have so many memories and have shared so many good times together as you guys have. So since looking back at year two, I have aged a lot. Look what you've done to me. I used to be this young person and now look at me, I'm old. I mean, look at that face. Definitely, you know. So year two was an amazing year. And I remember at the end of year two, it was so hard saying goodbye to you because I'd had the most incredible time. You know, we got through SATs together, all the amazing assemblies and productions and concerts and things that we did in year two that, you know, we need to remember. The dance festival, oh my goodness, trying to come up with a dance with you guys. Thank goodness that there's so many talented dancers in that class, because I wouldn't have had a hope. And you performed that in front of all those parents in the Wyvern. I mean, well done. But yeah, at the end of year two, it was really hard saying goodbye to you. And, you know, you guys were still going to be in school. And little did I know, just a couple of years later, I was stuck with you again in year five. Oh my goodness. Of course, when I actually found out that I had you in year five, I was so happy. But yeah, I had you again in year five. I felt so lucky to get to teach you again and to see how much you've grown and how much you've come on since teaching you in year two, because you are such a talented class. There are so many talented writers and readers and mathematicians and artists and dancers and sporters, I don't know what the correct word is, and seeing all of those talents blossom and grow, and in year five, you know, we had so many memories, boys that on the football team, we had the memory of our shocking defeat when we lost 10-0, I can't even remember the name of the school, I've tried to forget that memory, but you know, it's hard to forget, but we still had an amazing time, and the way you guys stuck with that and didn't give up, you really do need a pat on the back, so well done. But year five had loads of amazing memories, some of the trips that we went on. Who can forget that amazing memory of going to the Carinium Museum? We had our fantastic Series of Unfortunate Events assembly with Will as Count Olaf and the Baudelaire children as well. We had Olivia, Archie and Katie, obviously, as those. And everybody else who was in it, you know, you did such a fantastic job. And towards the end of year five, you know, I could feel that, you know, oh, I'm gonna have to say goodbye to them again. And then, would you believe it? Stuck with you again in year six. You're stuck with me. Year six, what a challenge. I mean, I'd never imagined I'd be doing not only year two SATs with you, but then thinking about year six SATs. And the amount of hard work that you guys put into revising for your SATs tests, well done. And to have that taken away from you, I know some of you might have been thinking, yes, I don't have to do the SATs. You worked so hard that it's such a shame that you didn't get to shine and, you know, show all that hard work that you've done. But, you know, never forget the amount of work you put into that, whether you did the SATs or not. You know, you deserve to be proud of what you've done, just as I'm proud of you. And, you know, you only joined us just towards the end of our time in Nyth. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for being a part of our class. And I'm sorry that I didn't get to know you more. Olivia, amazing, talented gymnast and dancer. You're going to go a long way with those skills. So well done and keep working at it. Akira, such a talented writer. I've enjoyed reading your stories. Incredible language and writer's style that you use. Please, you know, I cannot wait to read more of your books, and please send them my way when you do get published. Riley, such an incredible, talented, brave young man. The things that you can do in the, you know, in the woodland area, in the bushcraft, and the things that you've taught everyone, you know, you should be so proud of that, and I'm so proud of you. Maisie, such a talented young lady. I mean, maths, English, reading, all of those things. You're so hardworking and you should be so proud of everything that you've done. And I really do hope that one day you get that job in Nintendo in Japan. Jade, you know, you should be so proud of yourself. You should have more confidence in yourself because you are such a talented young lady, and you should be so proud of everything that you've done, because I'm proud of you. So, and your laugh is unforgettable. I love your laugh. Hayden, you know, you've battled through broken arms and all sorts of things since you've been at Knife. Such a talented football player. I think you're going to go a long way. Alexis, you should be so proud of everything that you've done since you've been at Knife. Such a sensible, helpful, hardworking person. You're amazing, so thank you. Frankie, again, somebody who's made me laugh. I remember in year two, one of my memories that I remember more than anything else is when I read a piece of writing about your dad's birthday and you described his boob cake that he was given. So thank you for that memory, and thank you for all the other memories, because you've made me laugh so much. I'm really proud of you, so well done. Crystal, thank you for sharing with us your passion for eco and for veganism, and you know, the things you've taught me. You really enlightened me with some of those things. You're such a passionate learner, so well done, and keep going. Peter, oh my goodness, you've made me laugh so much since I've known you. You really do have a brilliant sense of humour, and you've got such a clever scientific mind as well. The things that you can do with circuits are amazing, and I think you're going to go a long way, so thank you. Archie, such a talented sportsman and such a really grown up, sensible and mature young man. Again, talented sportsman, so polite, and thank you for being you, because you're brilliant. Maya, I mean, my goodness, Maya. You are incredible. Again, one of the memories I remember of you is that time when you almost fainted out in the woodland area, and we had to almost carry you back. Thank you for being you. Such a polite, thoughtful, kind, brilliant person. So thank you. Jimmy, amazing. I mean, you joined us at the start of year five and you fitted in so quickly. You and Hayden and Kira and everybody else who's joined since the beginning. You know, you fitted in so well, and you're such a polite, hardworking person. Really clever, really talented, and you know, so proud of you, so thank you. Harrison, I mean, Harrison, you are such a talented artist, drawer, painter, director, video director. You know, you should be so proud of yourself, and I never want you to doubt yourself, because you are such a talented young man, and I'm so proud of you and how much you've done, so please keep going. Caitlin, and what can I say, you know, I've never known somebody with such neat work. I wish everybody's work was as neat as you. And, you know, coming into school every day, that smile on your face, you work so hard. And you're, you know, you should be really proud of everything that you've done. You've come such a long way since year two. And I'm very proud of you. Mandisa, my goodness, Mandisa. Again, a talented artist, writer, you know, your reading is fantastic. The amount of effort you put into everything that you do is so commendable. And again, such a brilliant sense of humour. You have made me laugh and cry, you know, with laughter so many times. So thank you for being you. Owen, again, such a funny, talented person. You've put so much hard work into everything that you do. You should be so proud of the way you've, you know, you've come on since year two. I'm so proud of you. You, again, have made me laugh. You've impressed me with your writing. You've impressed me with how much you've grown and how much you've matured into the person that you are today, so thank you. Reese, such a talented mathematician. I mean, the amount of times that you've kept me on my toes in maths, the amount of times I've had to check my own answers because, you know, you've corrected me and like I said, kept me on my toes. Really talented writer and a really talented reader, and I'm so happy that you found a passion for reading and that you've really, you know, gone on with that and kept up with it, and you're gonna go a long way, so thank you. Katie, my goodness, you have made me laugh so much since you've been here. Since you've been part of the class, and who can forget, you know, Susan, the weird pencil that you used to carry around, and hopefully still do. I don't know where Susan is. Hopefully Susan is still alive and well, but thank you for being you. You are a talented gymnast, talented speaker, talented writer. You're going to go such a long way, and thank you for being part of the class. Shayla, again, you know, joined us sort of late in the year, but fitted in really well. Really confident young lady. And really proud of where you've come and how far you've come, and I hope that you keep working hard, keep trying your best, and continue to make people proud. So well done. Autumn, again, such a hard-working person. You have put your best into everything. You've tried so hard, and to watch you grow in confidence and to go from this kind of shy person that didn't, you know, speak out in class, to this really confident speaker who would happily, you know, take part in discussions and things. Really proud of you, well done. Kian, my goodness, you have come such a long way since year two. You know, the improvements you've made in your reading and writing and maths, You should be so proud of yourself. I hope you are, because I'm so proud of you. And again, talented footballer, such a polite, lovely, kind person. Keep it up. Never stop being you, because you're brilliant. Will, I mean, you are such an amazing speaker, such a confident speaker, so reliable, so polite, and so mature. You know, you work hard. I know there's been times when I had to tell you to keep concentrating, but you are such a clever young man, and I hope you keep working hard and keep doing your best and being the best that you are, because you're a very talented person, so well done. Luke, have I been a good boy? That still makes me laugh when you mention that in class. You've worked so hard. I mean, the leaps and bounds that you've come on with your handwriting, you should be really proud of that. I'm really proud of you. Keep working hard, keep up the good work, and I know you will do really, really well in secondary school. Clayton, again, joined us sort of towards the second part of year five and fit in really well. You know, you're such a talented artist. You try so hard. You sit and you listen and you take everything in, and I want you to keep working hard because you have been brilliant. So when I think about you guys, the word that comes to mind straight away is pride, because I am so proud of every single one of you. And it is really heartbreaking. It's really sad that it's had to end in this way. You know, it's so unfortunate that due to COVID-19 and the coronavirus that our time together was cut short, and we have missed out on some of the things, you know, that we were really looking forward to, like the residential and leavers assembly and, you know, all those nice things that unfortunately you guys have not been able to do. So even though we didn't have those fun times at the end of the year, we've had so many fun times together to look back on, and so many laughs, so many jokes, that, you know, we've got those memories which we're so lucky to have. And I feel so lucky to have been part of your time at Nyth. It is going to be so hard saying goodbye to you today, I guess, when you're watching this, but it's going to be so hard saying goodbye to you. And please, please, please come back and see me. I don't think I'll be able to cope without you guys coming and seeing me. I mean, how am I going to cope with a new class next year? Thank you. Thank you so much for being you guys. Like I said, I'm so proud of you. I'm going to miss every single one of you. I'm going to miss, you know, seeing your faces every day. So please keep working hard and keep making me proud, because you guys are amazing.